Yo, what is up, guys? What's going on? It's your boy Caveman back with another Red Dead Redemption 2. This time online money glitch video, guys. That's right, we are online officially on Red Dead Redemption 2, and this is the first of the money glitches right here. This is actually one of the best ones. There's a couple of them rolling around right now, guys. I'm sure you've seen them. Some of them I wouldn't even consider glitches, but you know, they do make you money. At least they're money methods or exploits, in my opinion. But this right here, this is the best that's gonna come out as of right now, and I recommend you guys get on this because it's real good, man. I mean, not a lot of people are even online right now, but as of Friday, everybody will be online. So for those of you who are online right now, you can definitely start taking advantage of this glitch right here. Now, this is going to work at two different locations, guys. We're going to be collecting jewelry, okay? And we're going to collect as much of this jewelry as possible. So this is unlimited. You can collect as much of this as possible, as much as you can carry. Go sell it and go keep collecting more jewelry, okay? So you're going to do this at two different locations. You don't have to do it at both locations. I'm giving you the option because there are two different locations. And as this gets more popular, let's be real, you're going to run into more issues with people doing this at the exact same location. Okay, you'll see what I mean, because you're going to be spawning into different lobbies and in different sessions, and you're going to be dealing with other people. Okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to go to this location that I'm showing you right here on the map. All right, it's going to be right here by this little creek river. Okay, and it's just going to be a couple of houses. You're going to see exactly what I mean once you get there. But what you're going to do is you're going to put yourself a waypoint right here to this house right here, that little square thing right there, and you're going to put yourself a waypoint right here. Once you make your way over to this house, okay, make sure that you're at the exact time I'm showing you guys. So that's wasting time looking around, okay? Look at everything around you so that you can see what the house looks like. Look, it's like a little log cabin looking thing. And you're just going to come right in through the front door, and you're going to go over to the cabinet on the right. Now, you're going to open up this cabinet, guys. Once you open up this cabinet, there's going to be two boxes of jewelry in this cabinet, all right? You're going to go ahead and take the box of jewelry, just like you see me do in the video. I'm going to go ahead and take that one right here that's right in front of my face, as you see it just shining right there. And there's another one right at the bottom. You're going to go ahead and take both of these, and as soon as you take both of them and you see that it pops up on the right there that you took the jewelry, you're just going to go ahead and hit start. Now you're going to scroll down to where it's on and just go into free roam, just like you see me doing the gameplay. You're going to accept the alert, and you're simply going to wait till you load up into a different session. When you load up into a different session, you're going to simply do that over again. Now, there is no timing with that, okay, guys? You can actually go around the house, and there's a couple of other things you can get that are not of value, but that can at least prevent you from spending a lot of money later on, like the potent snake oil, and there's some repeater cartridges, and there's a moonshine upstairs. So you have the option to go pick that up if you like. Now, like you see here, all I did was go into a new session, and it spawns me right by near where I was, okay? You see how pretty close I am to the house where I was, okay? So you're pretty close when you spawn back in. And all you're going to do is run right back over to the house, guys. You're going to go right back over to the house, and you're going to go right back to the same cabinet and get the jewelry. Now, once you get the jewelry, like I said, there is no timing, no speed with that. You know, I just didn't want to waste a bunch of gameplay showing you guys all this stuff when a lot of people don't even care about the moonshine or whatnot. But for those of you who do care, you can go around the house, and there's some moonshine, a couple things here and there. There's like a can of beans in the kitchen, you know, small things that might help you out if you're really, really, really broke, okay? But if not, just go over to the cupboard like you see me do here. I pull out the two things of jewelry, and boom, I go into another free roam session. So that's, guys, just simply going over there, getting the jewelry, and starting up a new one. Now here, this is the other location I was telling you guys about. I'm going to show you on the map exactly where this location is, okay? It's a bit of a ways away from the other one, but it's two options. You have two options in case you run into a lot of people at the other one or something. You want to try this one, you can try this one, guys. So once you're here at this location, what you want to do is, you see this house on the right, this big old like two-story thing, you don't want to go there. You want to go to this small one, okay? And as soon as you come into the front door right here, where this little dresser nightstand, whatever the hell this is, you see the jewelry right there. And you're going to do the exact same thing that we were doing at the other location. You're simply going to take the jewelry. Once you see it pop up that it registers that you got the jewelry, you're simply going to go ahead and hit online free roam session, accept the alert, guys. Just accept the alert, boom, you're good to go, and you're going to wind up in another session. session, just like the other one. You're just going to spawn you pretty close, okay? Pretty close to the point where you don't even need a horse. You're just going to run right back over there and do it over again. So as you see here in the gameplay, I'm just going to keep doing that over and over again. And this is unlimited, guys. You're limited by the amount of jewelry that you can carry, okay? At a certain point, you can't carry more than a certain number of earrings, for example, or a certain number of, watches or some shit like that, you know? So once you do start carrying to the max, you're going to go over to the fence and sell all this stuff, and you're going to make a shitload of money from this. Trust me that this is the best way to make money as of right now, guys. Get on this as quick as possible because jewelry's going to suffer the most, and if you collect a shitload of this, you're going to make a decent amount of change on this, man, for real, at least to get you started. It's nothing crazy, okay? Maybe a couple hundred bucks, maybe a thousand or two if you really get after it, but it's definitely going to help you out because you guys know how it is at the beginning of this. There's nothing, okay? Nothing. So hopefully this helps you guys out. You know, it gets you guys going. It gets you guys a little bit of money so you can at least try to get something going on this online, guys. You already know, man. I hope that you guys can hit this and everything's good to go. There really isn't nothing to hit. It's just switching sessions and grabbing jewelry. So nobody should have an issue with this, guys. And I really do hope this helps you guys out. Please smash the like button for your boy. Comment below. Let me know how you like the glitch. And don't forget to subscribe, guys, with post notifications so you don't miss out on future Red Dead Redemption and GTA Online glitches, guys. It's your boy, Caveman, and I'm out. Peace.